Hello, everyone, and good morning, good afternoon, or good evening, depending on when and where you are watching this video series on Singularity. Today, I bring you the third video in our series, and today we're going to talk about the makeup of a recipe or definition file so that you can build your very own container as opposed to just making use of pre-built containers. So a disclaimer to start, there are a ton of sections that can go into a recipe or definition file for a container, but we're just going to talk about three of these sections today, the environment section, the post section, and the run script section. As always, at the end of this video, we're going to ask a question that's going to touch on the topics we talk about during the slides, and we're going to go on quest, and we're going to go ahead and build our very own container to answer that question. All right. So one of the most convenient parts of building a container is the idea that you do not have to start from scratch. There are many, many containers already built out there. And instead of starting from scratch, what you want to do is build off of a container that somebody has already made. A very common example of this is what you can see in the slides, which is that Ubuntu already has a container that contains the base operating system. And what you want to do is make a container that bootstraps from or builds on top of that container. And so the two things you need to say is where does this container live? So in this case, Docker, so it's on Docker Hub. And then what is the name of the container? Who is the owner and what's the name? So very similar to when you do Singularity pull Docker colon /Ubuntu Groovy, right? You're gonna be essentially doing something very similar here, okay? So that's very convenient. The next section we're gonna talk about is the environment section. So as you may know, when you log on to a remote machine, a number of bash system variables are defined already for you and just other bash variables. If it's important or for convenience, you want to define a set of variables that will be defined inside the container, you can do so in this section. So in this example, I create a bash variable called myvar and assign it to this string. And myvar will be defined upon entering the container. The most important section of the Singularity definition or recipe file is the post section. And what post means is post bootstrap. So after you take the base layer container, what are the things you want to build on top of it? And the way you want to think about this is imagine you logged in to a brand new computer as the root or the admin user, and you wanted to install the software that you wanted to use. What are all of the commands in order that you would type in that situation in order to successfully install your program? You want to verbatim copy paste all of those lines of code you would have done at the terminal into the post section here. Okay. Finally, we have the run script section. So what this is saying that in this section, you want to imagine that after you installed this program using all of the commands in the post section, what would be the command you would enter in order to actually execute the new program you just installed? That's what you want to write in the run script section. Okay. Finally, you might be asking yourself, didn't I reference in video one that you need to have super user or root privileges in order to build a container? And that we don't have those privileges on a system like Quest, a shared computing system, which many of you may be using. And so this is very true. And this is where Sylabs, which is the the group that maintains and distributes Singularity, provides you with a way out. So they provide a cloud-based environment where you can upload your recipe file and have Singularity run in sudo in root mode in order to build the container on the cloud and then download it locally after it's done being built. So the remote part is very similar to the Singularity pull, and you essentially run a pull from the cloud after it's done being built, okay? And so all you need to do is create an account with Sylabs using your GitHub account. It's very easy. And then you can be on whatever system you have Singularity. You do a remote login, so you get a token. And then when you do the Singularity build command, you just add --remote. And so it will know to upload that recipe to the cloud, build the container on the cloud, and then download it locally. Okay, so that is kind of the bare bones of a recipe file and then how you build the container after you have this recipe file. And so what we're gonna do is we are going to do an exercise here. And the exercise that I'd like to do is we're gonna bootstrap off of a container that has Ubuntu installed in it. We're gonna install GNU C compiler version 10 into the container, and we're gonna then have that compiler compile a very simple C program, which just prints hello world. So that's all the container is gonna do. It's gonna run a very simple C program, which will print the words hello world. Okay, so let's go ahead and just get right to it. So as always, I'm gonna be on Quest for today's video. I also have a folder already made for the third video in this series. So the first thing you're gonna wanna do when you want to build a container using Singularity is you are going to want to log in to Sylabs so that you can build your container on the cloud. Okay, and so again, you do not have root privileges on a machine like Quest or other high performance computing environments, but Sylabs provides you the opportunity to build with root privileges on the cloud and then download the container that you built locally after you're done doing so. So you simply run Singularity remote login. Normally what would happen is you would get a URL that you would put in your web browser. You would authenticate and create an token that you would then copy locally here, and you would then be authenticated to build on the remote builder. In my case, I've already done this step, so I'm not gonna replace the access token that I already made and copied over to Quest here. And then once you're logged in, you're ready to go, okay? So the first thing you wanna do is make a definition file. So you can open up a new file called myrecipe.def with a text editor of your choice. I'm gonna use Vim. And the very first question you need to ask yourself, as we alluded to in the slides, is what container would you like to be the base container level layer that you then build on top of? And then also, once you've determined which container you would like to build on top of, you want to also note where does that container live, okay? So in my case, we are going to build on top of a container that lives on Docker Hub. And the name of that container is going to be the latest release of Ubuntu here soon, okay? So I'm gonna start with a container that has the base operating system Ubuntu installed in it already, and run commands on top of that that will be necessary to install the program that I want to run in the container, okay? So after you've determined which container you would like to build on top of, the second step is to list out the commands that you would like to run in order to install your program. So again, imagine you had just been connected with a terminal window to a brand new computer, what commands would you run in order to install your program? Okay, so the first thing to do that's always smart when you have a new install of an operating system is to quickly update any of the packages in the base operating system and make sure everything in the container is up to date. And the second thing you want to do is install any packages or dependencies you need in order to compile or run your program. So in my case, I need GCC 10. Now you may be asking, how did I know what the name of the GCC 10 compiler package was? Well, one of the tools that I like using is packages.org. And you can see here, I search for GCC 10 and I look for my operating system. In this case, Ubuntu Hirsu. All right. And then I click on the GCC 10 base. Okay. But I like using this to find out what the name of my package is. So in my case, the package name is GCC 10. Okay. And then the next step is to compile the program. So in my case, I'm going to compile the program and install it into a directory called optbin. Now, again, you have root privileges when you make this container, and that includes the ability to create files or a hierarchy of files and folders that don't exist in the base operating system. So opt is not a folder that exists in Ubuntu by default, but you can create it in your own container because you have root privileges. The next step is I'm going to create the C file that's gonna print hello world to the screen. So there is a way in Singularity to have a local file and upload it with the container so that you don't have to do something like I'm doing, which is reverse engineer the hello world C program through a set of print statements. But I'm not going to do that here. I'm going to create the C program on the fly and then compile it. Okay. And so I'm going to create this program in the opt folder. So opt hello world.c. And I'm going to copy this line 5 times because there are 5 lines to our basic hello world program. Okay. So the second line is I declare the name of the C program. It's going to be called main. And then in the third line, I actually print hello world. Okay. Then I end the function call. And then I end the whole function by closing it off with a curly bracket. Okay, so this is all the lines of code needed to print hello world in a C program. And now the final step is to use the GCC 10 compiler to compile hello world.c and install it into the optbin folder. Okay. So that's all you do in the post section. You just imagine every command you would run in order to install the dependencies of your program and compile your program. And finally, in the run script section, you want to imagine after you did everything in the post section, what is the command you would run to actually execute your program? And in my case, it's simply optbin hello world. That is sufficient. That's the only program I installed in here, and that will print hello world. Okay. So now that I've finished this, I can save this file and quit. And I now use the Singularity build command with the remote flag enabled, because again, we're going to build this on the cloud, not locally on Quest. And I name the container and call it mycontainer.sif. Okay. And then I feed it the recipe or the definition file. And so you can see the first thing that it does is authenticate me. Okay. So it knows that I've logged in and that I have an account with Sylabs so that it can build on the cloud. Okay. And then it runs, as I mentioned, essentially each command line or each line you put in the post section of the recipe file, line by line, as if you had a terminal open with root privileges. Okay. So it updates all of the packages. It then installs the GCC 10 package. And this will be many lines. People who are familiar with Ubuntu are familiar with the apt package manager and are probably familiar that this is how it looks when you install a system library using the apt package manager. Okay. And then finally, it runs the make directory command. It creates the C program, and then it runs the GCC command. Okay. And this is a good time to demonstrate how the error that you would expect to get if you messed up a command on the command line is the same thing that the build step of the container or building the container will give you if one of your commands doesn't work out or has an error associated with it. It will exit the entire build of the container. So here, this is a very simple error that I've made. And so I'll just correct it here. No need to redo everything from scratch. Okay. The only thing I didn't do was I gave it the path to the program I wanted to compile, but I did not feed the dash O option, which is to say, what do I want to call the program? Hello world. I want to call it hello world. And this is where I want to install it. Okay. So all I have to do is make a tweak to my post section and run it again. So again, you can kind of iteratively, you know, if you're not quite sure each and every command needed, you can iteratively try again with small tweaks until you get the install instructions just right. Okay. So this will finish up pretty quickly here. And then once it's successful, it's going to do essentially a Singularity pull and pull the container into the folder that I ran the build command in. Okay. And then I'm going to run Singularity run. And if I did things correctly, it should run the program hello world and print hello world to the screen. Okay. So again, what we'll do is we'll run Singularity run my container. And then I'm also going to use Singularity exec so that you can see how Singularity run is really just a special form of the Singularity exec command. It's not really any different. So it's downloading a container about 1112 megabytes. Okay, and then I'm gonna run Singularity run my container. You can see it prints hello world. And I could do the same thing by doing Singularity exec my container.sif with the full path to hello world as where it lives again in the container. So the I'll clear the terminal window one more time so you can see that better. Okay, so again, opt bin hello world, that's where my program lives inside the container, and therefore I can run Singularity exec on that program, even though there is no folder, although there is a folder called opt on quest, there is no opt bin hello world. That's only something that exists inside of the container. So thank you so much for joining me for the third video in our series. As always, I'm going to leave us with a possible answer to the question. I encourage you to try and build your own container using your own definition or recipe file. You don't have to, you could try writing a C program locally and uploading it with the container instead of trying to write the C program on the fly. And I hope people join me next time for the final video in our series, which is going to be advanced container usage. We're going to explain how you can make some of those commands like running Singularity exec simpler on yourself when you're running on an HPC system, because some of the commands can be quite cumbersome. And we're going to talk about how we can use modules to help with that, as well as how to run MPI programs inside containers. So thank you all for listening, and I'll see you next time.